Yes, please introduce.
Hi all, I am Akhil. I am pursuing my fourth year B.Tech in Civil Engineering from Sahadya College of Engineering and Technology.
So what is your statement for Rakhi?
My dear opponent, let's debate and let's converge into a solution that is non-disastrous to the community.
Thank you so much. Yes, Rakhi, please introduce.
Good morning, everyone. I am Rakhi Krishna of Amata School of Pharmacy. I am a fifth year pharmacy student. And my message to you is that we both will be able to make a good debate and hope we make it to the next session in order to make it to the other topics like these too.
So there are so sweet, so we can have a big round of applause for both of them. And here we go. Wait, the four. I'm sorry, I didn't hear you. Okay, thank you. Well, for the motion, your 1 minute starts right now.
Every action will have an equal and an opposite reaction. This is actually what we are witnessing in case of Hartals. A legacy, a reflection legacy, was Gandhiji showed us a moment of civil disobedience that can lead us into the disruptions of the colonialism and leading into the liberation of our nation. But this motion or this idea was being transformed into a setup where violence was being engaging and disrupting the economy and the total setup and equilibrium of our nation, or especially our state. Last year, we witnessed more than 50 hartals, that is exactly 97 hartals, along with the previous year we witnessed 120 hartals. Actually, what we are here, our state is enjoying the most about holidays and places of promoting actual violence. Let me ask one thing, simple thing. How can someone think in a violent setup? Innovation should take place when peace is practiced.
Thank you. Against the motion, we have 1 minute starts now.
Democracy has evolved through popular struggles. If I were to remain silent, I would be guilty of my complexities too. So rightly said by Sir Albert Einstein. Where everyone here is opposing that hartal is a hindrance to the society. Let me ask you, my friends, what is the real definition of progress? Progress is an idea to evolve in all aspects of life in order to generate a better human living conditions, which is readily denied in a developing country like India. But just taking a GDP to measure the progress, it is not apt, where the basic fundamental rights, the opportunities and the basic needs of humans are getting denied. Whereas a hartal lends the ears in order to bring out the injustices and voice the displeasures that is present. Not only just mentioned by Kerala here, there are civil disobedience movements, the Jallikattu hartals, the farmers and the nurses hartals, and various hartals that had taken place and which was able to conceal the demands of the government.
Time up. And now give 3 minutes, your time starts now.
Studies of Aligarh University shows that 4.2% decrease in the GDP of average of our nation. This is actually the gross domestic product of the total Indian sale of our commodities of the state. This is actually a decrease. How can this happen? This is because when we shut down our shops and everything.
Okay.
Also, I would like to point out the Cambridge University study regarding the progress, where it says that GDP alone as a marker to study the progress is a bad definition. Whereas you should be considering the various other factors like the social development, the fundamentals for the living conditions, the basic rights, the disability areas and all these. When you consider the population alone, you will be considering about the GDP. What about the minor things that happen to the simple person in the world? Like consider the farmers. The farmers are not given the proper wages, they are not given the loan waivers, etc. Don't they have to come out and protest, and don't they have to get their demands from the government?
A year has 365 days. Last year, our students only got 143 days average to have their studies. From this, we understand that our state government is providing our students with an immense portion. Here, the students will be demolishing, their students will lose their time. They will have to concentrate more on their time for studies, and they are losing their actually time for their creativity. A peace mind can make innovations. The students can create wonders. And when these type of innovations are disrupted, how can students create wonders?
Okay, got your
point. First of all, the creativity can happen anywhere, not just the four walls of the school. Moreover, I would like to point out the Navanirman Andolan that took place in Gujarat, where the students had to come out in order to say against the injustices conducted by the government which was so corrupt, and that movement itself was able to topple the government and bring a good government there.
Okay. IBS chief once given an interview of CNN already dismissed that. The IT companies are failing to invest in Kerala sector because of the hartals, and their professionals cannot be work upon it. Cherry Brunsman, the CEO of GE Solutions, is failing to invest on Kerala because of this. BMW failed to invest. Actually, we are losing mass investment and we are losing our employment abilities.
As I have already told, don't just take the GDP to measure the progress. The investments can happen anywhere. Why are we just considering the Kerala as such? There are various other movements which whereby the government could bring out the new responses because of, like, consider the Jallikattu movement as well as the Narmada Bachao Andolan, where they were able to bring out the new aspects which was earlier not considered by the government, or taking in consideration that they were a minority as such.
Please. Gandhiji showed us the path of non-violence. He never showed us the path of violence.
Yeah, time up. Thank you so much. Now you have 30 seconds to conclude your statement. Your time starts now.
We are Indians. We stand by the rights. We are having some fundamental rights. But let me tell you something. One right cannot compensate the other. Let us all have rights, and let our rights cannot be denied. Hartal is our maybe our right to have our protection. But we can express our protest through different ways. But not by disrupting the right of other persons.
Thank you. Against the motion, your 30 seconds starts now.
First of all, I would like to say to my opponent that the Gandhiji's non-violence principle is applicable in the hartals too. It's the hartal sans violence. So coming, which invention hasn't been questioned and which discovery hasn't been debated. So likewise, without criticism, a country or an administration cannot survive. No democracy can succeed. So rightly said by Sir John F. Kennedy, where we demand by hartal is the transparency of the government in order to bring out what is truly ours, and just to mention the displeasures.
Thank you so much, friends. Please come forward, both of you. So can we big round of applause for both of them?
For India.